Very good morning to all the students. Beta, we are going to start new chapter, My Childhood. So this is actually autobiographical account. If you have heard about a book written by APJ Abdul Kalam, Wings of Fire, he has given, this is beta, Wings of Fire. You must note down this name. This book is actually the autobiography of APJ Abdul Kalam. You get to know about everything about his life, about his childhood, about his schooling, his college, how he achieved, how he became what he's known till date, even after his death, right? So this chapter is extract from the book. You'll be getting a peep into his childhood memories. Still students are joining. So let me introduce few characters today. There are many characters in this chapter. The moment they would be entering, I would be introducing you all, fine? So first and foremost character, whose autobiographical account we are going to read? APJ Abdul Kalam. Everybody knows this one of the finest president, the way he, you can say, fulfilled his responsibilities. Sorry. Fine, then we have Jainuladdin, who's his father. Clear? Then Ashi Amma, she's the mother. Then I have written friends in bracket and we have the list of friends. Ramanand Shastri, Arvindan and Shri Prakashan. Fine. So we will be reading, these are the characters which we'll be reading about whom today we'll be reading, but there are more characters. And I would be showing you one video first. Then we'll continue about APJ Abdul Kalam. Fine. Let's see a glance into his life.
Good morning, everyone.
Obviously, I was.
And was made the director of Defense Medical.
Yes, from the beginning.
Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Real life journey is an inspiration for young and old. Dr. Abdul Kalam Jainuladdin Abdul Kalam was born on 15th October 1931 at Rameshwaram in Tamil Nadu. His father Jainuladdin was a wealth farmer and his mother Ashi Amma was a homemaker. He came from a financially poor background and used to distribute these programs to support his family.
So as you can see, beta, in this picture, you can see they have already written the name over there, Abdul Kalam, along with his siblings and parents. Fine. His father and mother, Ashi Amma and Jainuladdin. So very simple family and very humble background he came from. But he is the man who never stopped working hard. You know, when we are at, when you all are teenagers, you might not have even thought in your life that you will be working at this age. So when he was a teenager only, he started selling newspapers because one of his cousin would do so. And he was in need of helping hand. World War II was going on. Family circumstances were not that good. Though he was having basic amenities of life, his father gave very good, you can say, education and proper food and clothing to all the, you can say, children. But they were not that rich that they were enjoying luxurious life. Basic amenities they were leading, fine. But even then he did not, that's why he learned the value of hard work in his life from his parents and his mother. Let me tell you about the mother. Was so empathetic lady. She would feed hundreds of poor people. Though they could not afford much, even then, she was always ready to serve food to needy. So every day on their home, APJ Abdul Kalam would see that mother and father, they were feeding poor and needy people. Though they were also not rich, but whatever they could do, they were doing. So that was the leading, you can say, quality was coming from parents only, that how they used to help others and how hardworking they were. So, this was the school. You need to remember this name, Rameshwaram Elementary School, because this story is all about his childhood life. And later we'll be getting a glimpse of what he did later, fine? So how he was as a student, how he led his life, who were his friends, some incidents with the teacher, fine?
In 1954, he graduated in physics from St. Joseph's College in Tiruchirappalli. In 1955, he joined the Madras Institute of Technology and studied aerospace engineering. Dr. Kalam's dream was to become a fighter pilot, but he was ranked 9th while the IAF offered only 8 slots. He was a very simple person who owned a few possessions.
Now see, we always believe in accumulating branded clothes, you know, televisions, computers, headphones, and whatnot. Our houses and homes are filled with so many things which even we do not look at and we don't have time even to use even. But what sort of living this simple man was having? Let's have a look.
Including a simple coat, a lungi, his beloved veena, and a collection of birds.
This picture says it all. He used to play veena. This is not sitar. Veena is just like sitar, but it is a musical instrument he loves to play. He used to play and he would read books. You can see a simple bed, simple room. Though even, you know, when he became president, even at that time, he was not relishing the facilities given to a president. He was just living in a humble background, very simple room, fine. All throughout his life, he just, what he needed, he used that. What he never needed, he never even kept it in his room.
He didn't even have the television. He was a kind-hearted man with no show of love. His love for children was always evident. As soon as the program got over, he would cross the barricades to interact freely with the children, speak at length with them, and motivate them to take up challenges. APJ Abdul Kalam's birthday, up to 15, was celebrated as World Students Day. Dr. Kalam emerged as a superb team leader and a technologist for excellence in the scientific field. From 1963 to 1980, his career was spent in space research with the founding of India's space program by Vikram Sarabhai under the Indian Committee for Space Research, which became ISRO. The successful launch of the satellite launch vehicle SLV-3 was a high flight of Kalam's space tent, which propelled India into a select band of countries with rocket launching capability.
So you see how a person from very humble background and how he reached heights or zenith of success. And till date, we salute this man. He is the, you know, one of the prominent presidents that children loved, and he loved the children. Anybody knows how he died? Anybody of you knows that where was he when he died? Divya knows. Okay, Divya, you can answer it, beta.
Ma'am, he died due to a heart attack.
He died of heart attack, yes, cardiac arrest. And what was he doing at that time? Jatin knows, yes. Jatin, you can answer. Karanveer, you can answer.
Ma'am, he is giving a speech.
Yes.
On stage.
Yes. At that time also, he was in one of the universities giving his speech. You know, he was a very good teacher. Even when he was, you know, he completed his services as president, even then he was, you know, giving workshops and giving motivational speeches and lectures to various students of schools and colleges in India and even in abroad. So he worked till his last breath. Even when he died on a stage. And when he gave his speech, he was about to finish his speech or almost finished. He fell down on the stage. When he was taken to hospital, it was announced that he's dead and he died of cardiac arrest, heart attack. So such kind of personalities who really literally worked till his last breath, and he served humanity in true spirits rather than, you know, boasting about or accumulating. You know, we people keep on running after accumulating cars and clothing, and he remained very simple with very simple hair. So people would make fun even then, what sort of hairstyle and what the kind of looks he was having. But no, looks are temporary. What is permanent in our life is what you become, what sort of a person you are, how you carry yourself, how you treat others. And the way he treated others is commendable. Fine? So let's read the chapter. One more video I would be showing you tomorrow that is based on the true incident and which is mentioned in this chapter only. Fine? Can you think of any scientists who have also been statesmen? Fine? Statesmen means people of government. Those who are part of political system. He was a, you can say, a person who was a scientist, a person who was a teacher, a person who was a statesman also. Everything he was doing, such a knowledgeable man he was. APJ Abdul Kalam, whose projects in space, defense, and nuclear technology guided India into the 21st century, became our 11th president in 2002. Underline this. When he was elected the president in 2002, and he was the 11th president of India. In his autobiography, Wings of Fire, he speaks of his childhood. So mark this book, very important. If you can read it, definitely go for it. So very inspirational book it is, Wings of Fire. He would be telling his whole journey. I was born into a middle-class Tamil family in the island town of Rameshwaram, in the erstwhile Madras, former Madras, fine, state. Earlier it was known as Madras. So he was born in a very middle-class Tamil family. He was a Tamilian, fine, in the island town of Rameshwaram. My father, Janulabdin, had neither much formal education nor much wealth. So his father, he could not, you know, complete his education, and he was not a wealthy, rich person, despite these disadvantages. So these two disadvantages were there. Even then, his father possessed great innate wisdom and a true generosity of spirit. He was very generous, very kind, and he was very wise. Some people are not educated, but they're wise. Some people are very well educated, but even then they are not wise. So wisdom does not come from education only. Wisdom comes, it is innate ability, how your parents have given you the values. He had an ideal helpmate in my mother, Ashiyamma. So, you know, husband and wife both were very supportive to one another. During those times when women were not considered equal to men, his father was the one who considered his wife as equals. Both were working as helpmates to one another. So mother's name is Ashiyamma, father's name is Janulabdin. You should know the characters. I do not recall the exact number of people she fed every day, but I am quite certain that far more outsiders ate with us than all the members of our own family put together. Means total number of family members were less, but the people to whom they were feeding, outsiders were more, who would come into their house and she would happily and lovingly feed them. I was one of many children, a short boy with rather undistinguished looks, born to tall and handsome parents. So he's telling us very, you know, innocently and very, in a very humble way, he's accepting that I was not at all handsome. He's saying my parents were handsome, my parents were tall, but I was born like this only. We lived in our ancestral house, which was built in the middle of the 19th century. It was a fairly large pakka house made of limestone and brick on the Mosque Street in Brahmeshwaram. So underline, this is the address of APJ Abdul Kalam's house. He used to live in the Mosque Street, though they were not rich, but they were not poor also. They were living in a pakka house made up of bricks in the Mosque Street in Brahmeshwaram. My austere father used to avoid, austere means simple, strict and severe, though they were very simple people, but he was very disciplinarian. He was very simple man, follower of rules. His father used to avoid all inessential comforts and luxuries. I told you that these things come from family, from parents. His parents were like that. They were, you know, living life having essential commodities only. But we people keep on running about after the things which even we do not need in our life. So man of very meager means. However, all necessities were provided for in terms of food, medicine or clothes. He was fulfilling all the basic needs of his children, medicine, clothes, food. In fact, I would say mine was a very secure childhood, both materially and emotionally. What does a child need at the time of when he's growing up? He needs the emotional support of his parents, good food. When he's sick, he needs medicine, a house to live in, and loving and caring parents. And this is what we all need. And he was having all those things. And he was so happy and grateful for this. The things are, we are never grateful. You know, we keep on cribbing ki ye nahi hai, wo nahi hai. Jo hai, wo to dekho. What we are having, we should be thankful to God. That God, thank you, you have given us this body. You have given us food. You have given us clothes. So, the Second World War broke out in 1939, underline. When I was 8 years old, at the time of Second World War, APJ Abdul Kalam was 8-year-old boy. For reasons I have never been able to understand, a sudden demand for tamarind seeds erupted in the market. Now, he is going to discuss the time when he worked hard like anything. How he worked. There was a time, beta, at that time, medicines were not there. You know, doctors were not easily available. People were having, you can say, homemade solutions to all the problems because no ailments were also not there to that extent. So people would follow a norm in the society. So during those days, because World War II was going on, many diseases were also spreading and people were having tamarind seeds. Demand increased. Fine? Imli jo hoti hai aapki. I used to collect the seeds and sell them to a provision shop on Mosque Street. He never hesitated to work hard even at the age of 8. You know, 8-year-old boy, he would collect all the seeds and he would sell them to a shop on Mosque Street jahan pe wo rehte the. A day's collection would fetch me the princely sum of 1 anna. Now, 1 anna is an old Indian coin, means 6 paise. फाइन, यू पीपल माइट नॉट हैव इवन सीन पैसे, हमने भी नहीं देखे रुपीज ही है, क्वाइंस ही है, बट वी हैव सीन द क्वाइंस ऑफ पैसे. सो ही वुड अर्न 6 पैसे ओनली एंड इवन देन ही वुड सेल दोज टैमरिंड सीड्स, यू नो, फर्स्ट जॉब अंडरलाइन. देन माई ब्रदर इन लॉ जलालुद्दीन वुड टेल मी स्टोरीज अबाउट द वॉर विच आई वुड लेटर अटेम्प्ट टू ट्रेस इन द हेडलाइंस इन दीनामणि. Our area being isolated was completely unaffected by the war. So they were lucky that Rameshwaram, that place where they were living, the mosque street, the Rameshwaram place, that was far away from where that world war was going on. They were not at all affected. So he would hear those news excerpts from his brother-in-law Jalaluddin. Because they hail from Muslim family, that's why their names are like this only. So their area was isolated, secluded, different. But soon India was forced to join the allied forces and something like a state of emergency was declared. Immediately, there was an announcement by the government that it is a case of emergency for all the people living in India because world war was going on, anything can happen. The first casualty came in the form of suspension of the train halt at Rameshwaram station. Now the time was becoming worse. Even trains were not allowed to halt at stations. So now they were not able to get newspapers properly. Newspapers now had to be bundled and thrown out from the moving train on the Rameshwaram road between Rameshwaram and Dhanushkodi. The cousin of APJ Abdul Kalam, his name was Samsuddin. He would work as newspaper seller. And because of this, quite fast he had to move because bundles of newspaper would be thrown away from the running train and they would have to catch it and do the work. So he asked APJ Abdul Kalam that whether he would help him. Who asked? Samsuddin, his cousin, who distributed newspapers in Rameshwaram. So Samsuddin was cousin of, I told you many characters would be coming, you keep on underlining. So Samsuddin, cousin of APJ Abdul Kalam, asked him, who was already a newspaper distributor, that I need a helping hand to catch the bundles. And naturally, I filled the slot. I filled the slot means APJ Abdul Kalam, he himself started working for or working with his cousin. Samsuddin helped me earn my first wages. When he sold those tamarind seeds, he was not earning wages. He was just getting a few paise only. But now proper wages he got. Half a century later, I can still feel the surge of pride in earning my own money for the first time. He's saying, even after 50 years, I'm proud of what I did in the past. If somebody asks you, suppose, that can you sell newspapers on daily basis at this stage? We will be very ashamed that no, this work is very, you know, small. We people are not born to do such work. We have bifurcated the works that selling newspaper is bad, but sitting in a showroom and selling clothing, branded clothes is class. This is all mindset. APJ Abdul Kalam never hesitated in any work. For him, work was work. Neither it was small or big. Every child is born with some inherited characteristics into a specific socio-economic and emotional environment. But Beta, we are not left with much time. So we will be continuing this paragraph tomorrow. But before that, we have 2-3 minutes. A few minutes are there. I would like to ask you people a few questions now. Tell me the name of APJ Abdul Kalam's parents. Raise your hand. Quickly. Raise your hand. Yes, Dhairya Chadda is the first one to raise hand.
Ma'am, his father name is Jainulabdin and his mother name is Ashima.
Ashima, very good. Now, mother's name is mother apostrophe s, fine. Father's name, father apostrophe s. In that way, you will be speaking. Didiksha, the question is done. I won't be repeating the same question. My second question is, give a brief description of the place and city where APJ Abdul Kalam lived. Tell me about the city. So Titiksha is the first one to raise hand. Answer it.
APJ Abdul Kalam lived in Tamil Nadu. He was born in the small city of Rameshwaram. His family was not so rich, but they can afford the simple commodities of the life.
Fine, I'm not asking about family, only the place. Fine, you have to tell about Rameshwaram, you have to tell about in the erstwhile it was called Madras state. Fine, he was born in middle class Tamil family in the islet town of Rameshwaram. Okay, the place. So now tell me about the qualities of his parents. What we have read so far about his father and mother. What sort of a person? Bell has gone. So nobody is raising hand except Titiksha. Titiksha, you won't get a chance today. You have already given answer. So, okay, beta. So we will be continuing tomorrow. Keep reading, and you have a test on Saturday of Snake and the Mirror. Keep preparing, keep reading, okay? It will be a Google form test only. Have a nice day.